It's been a long two years for the travel industry, with our borders shut for a significant amount of that time. Flights have been limited, staff have been laid off, and for most of us, our travel plans put on hold. But now, game on, right? People are jumping at the chance to jet off. But with an industry still playing catch up with staffing shortages, not to mention the COVID illnesses many workplaces are grappling with, customers are often being left in the lurch with complaints of cancelled flights, lost luggage, and other headaches. Shortly, we're going to chat to Flight Centre's Kristill Loxton to talk about what you can do if you get caught short. But first, I spoke to an Auckland dad who had his school holiday travel plans ruined.
Yeah, it was quite frustrating, Maddie. You know, we had pushed this twice because of COVID. So it was myself and my wife and our two teenagers. And this is Friday night, and we're due to fly out 9 o'clock Saturday morning. And I get a text at about midnight telling me that the flight's cancelled. So immediately I'm thinking, well, what do we do here? So I got on the phone. It was about 2.5 hours, 2 hours 45 by the time I got through, to be told the next available flight was Tuesday evening. So that kind of threw our plans into disarray. So in the end, we had to cancel. I had lots of restaurants booked. We had skiing booked at Cadrona. All of that's been cancelled. So all of that money that was going to go into the economy down there, which I know they desperately need, is not going to happen.
What were you told about the reasons for the cancellation?
We were told crew issues, and when we finally spoke to the supervisor, they told us it was crew sickness.
Oh, that must have been so frustrating.
Yeah, frustrating. And you know, you'd like to think they could have planned a little bit more for this, but you know, it's difficult, right, at the moment with staffing and sicknesses and all of that going on. So we understand, but yeah, we're frustrated.
So what now, Chris?
Well, I'm back at work, Maddie, as you can see. And yeah, my wife and family are back at home. And yeah, it's not terrible. We live on Waiheke Island, so you know, we'll get over it. First world problem, as I said to them the other day. But frustrating, right?
Yeah, it is frustrating. But Kristill Loxton from Flight Centre Travel Group joins me now to talk about what you possibly could do if you find yourself in a situation like that. Morena. Good morning, Kristill.
Good morning, Maddie.
Thank you so much for coming in. Let's start with the positives. First of all, how fantastic is it that we're even talking about travel?
Oh, so exciting. We're at Flight Centre Travel Group. We're absolutely overwhelmed and over the moon that travel is back.
Yeah, but as you heard from Chris, with that comes some headaches for customers. Mm-hmm. How indicative is Chris's situation for travellers at the moment?
Just speaking generally on behalf of the industry, Maddie, I'll talk about you know, a couple of things that are impacting all of us at large, and two things specifically. One is airline capacity. International airfare capacity, for example, into New Zealand is currently sitting at around 40%, which means that the seats, available seats in and out of New Zealand are far lower than what they were pre-COVID. However, Flight Centre are currently trading at approximately 80% of travel, so the demand for travel is far greater than the available seats. So when it comes to, you know, rebooking impacted customers, it's trickier because it's less availability on flights to be able to do that. But that will change. By the end of the year, we'll have, you know, up and over 70% of the capacity back and almost be at 100% of the domestic capacity, which will make a really big difference to, you know, the disruptions. The second, which you've sort of mentioned as well, is staffing. So, you know, sadly, it's front of mind for the entire industry, the entire travel industry, as it is with other industries around New Zealand and around the world. Sadly, we had to let a number of people go. Some of those people have moved on into different careers. They've needed to be, you know, retrained. We're really proud and grateful and fortunate at Flight Centre that, you know, over 80% of our new recruits are ex-flighties, and it's a priority for us to welcome those people back. But we are on the hunt now for, you know, new flighties to join our team and help us to open up the world for those that want to see. And look, large scale, you know, recruitment does take time, but we're, you know, we're moving at pace, and really our challenge is that travel has, you know, rebounded to an extraordinary level, and our challenge as an industry is, you know, to upscale at that same pace.
Yeah, and Chris mentioned it as well. You understand it. I mean, it's been a long two years, but people are desperate to get out there and travel again. So it's patience, right? People just need a little bit of patience as the industry catches back up.
Yeah, and it can be hard to muster patience at a time of frustration when your travel's, you know, been disrupted, yeah. particularly with all of that pent-up demand. But as somebody who travels frequently and as a, you know, a travel industry veteran, I can assure you that it does help in these situations.
Yeah. Obviously, Chris had in this situation with a cancelled flight. We recently travelled to Australia and had lost luggage, which I know a lot of people were grappling with at the moment. Are those the biggest things that people will have to be dealing with if they're looking to travel at the moment?
Yeah, look, I expect so. And all of that will ease as time goes on and we jump over this hurdle. Look, I think for, you know, any travellers, you know, my advice would be just to, if you find yourself in a situation where you've got a disruption or something hasn't gone to plan, you know, get in touch with, you know, seek to understand what your options are so you can make an informed decision. Get in touch with who you booked with, ask lots of questions and understand what the next steps are and also, you know, what options are available to you. If you've purchased travel insurance, and travel insurance has always been really important domestically and internationally, but domestically it's becoming, you know, more popular than it used to be. If you purchase travel insurance, contact your provider, understand, you know, what you can, what you can't claim, and that will also inform your decision. And as we talked about already, patience. And look, lastly, and this perhaps sits outside of disruption, but a big piece of advice is if you can book in advance, do it, particularly while capacity is low. It will give you choice and it will also, you know, potentially reduce the cost of, you know, the fear as
How long are you expecting things to go on like this before the industry can play catch up with demand?
Yeah, really, really good question. We're, you know, as a global organisation, we're constantly in contact with our counterparts around the world. And, you know, in other regions around the world, they're already at a place where the challenges have eased. And the contributing factors have been, you know, the airline capacity and the upscale in you know, in staffing. So, as I said, by the end of the year, you know, each month the airline capacity increases and that makes a considerable difference. And then, you know, each month we've got more people, you know, trained and ready to go. So, look, I think it's any time. I think as we move forward, it's not a definitive line, but as we move forward, these issues will ease, and not just for Flight Centre Travel Group, but the industry at large.
And like you said, like we said at the start, it is so great that we can even talk about these kinds of things. I mean, what a problem to be faced with, right?
Agreed. Agreed. It's really exciting.
Yeah. Let's get back out into the world. Thank you so much, Kristill, for joining us. We really appreciate it. That is Kristill Loxton from Flight Centre Travel Group. Really appreciate your insight this morning.
Thanks, Maddie.
Thank you so much.